Hello everyone and welcome back to the Scale Model Medic YouTube channel. Sorry that I've been gone such a long time, but I'm back now for 2014 and in this video I'm going to be seeing what I can do with the Revel Easy Kit Millennium Falcon to see if I can build this into a decent budget replica of the Star Wars classic. The Finemolds Millennium Falcon is widely regarded as the best kit of this vehicle on the market, so this was the first thing I tried to find to see if I could get my hands on one. A quick search of eBay turned up one example for sale in the UK, but the selling price of £419.99 came as a bit of a shock to me. I have literally bought cars in my lifetime for less than £419.99, so no, I'm afraid I won't be building the Finemolds kit in this video. Now, even though the Finemolds kit is very expensive, it's also very detailed. This is a compromise I'm going to have to make, as the Easy Kit is a snap together kit that requires no glue or paint and is aimed squarely at kids or beginners. It's all very rugged and simplified and designed to be played with, however on unboxing this kit I was pleasantly surprised at the contents. Even though the pre-painting is quite crude in places, the level of surface detail and the quality of casting is actually rather good. The upper and lower hull in particular contain some really nice panel line detailing, all of which is very crisp and will take a nice pin wash when it comes to weathering later. Taking a closer look at some of the details again, we can find some more of the compromises that I'll have to make on this kit. Because the hull is moulded as one large piece, any areas which needed definition have just been lumped in and we now have these huge solid tabs of plastic where these pipes would have protruded out over the recesses in the hull. All things considered then, for the price this looks like it's actually going to build into a half decent replica of the Millennium Falcon. The kind of people who will see this model when it's complete are the visitors to my house, who are a mixture of average sci-fi fans, and they're not going to notice the fact that the greebles on the side of this kit aren't the famous mishmash of previous model kit parts that you can find on the actual Star Wars props themselves. With that in mind, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to update the details, and I'm going to use this as a nice easy starter to get me back into creating videos for the Scale Model Medic channel. I'm also going to throw the kitchen sink at it in terms of weathering and painting techniques, but all of that will follow in the second video once I've done the updates. First things first, I'm going to take some coated wire, which is thick steel wire that's been covered in plastic, and I'm going to use this to replace those moulded on pipes on the surface of the Falcon, which stick out over the recesses in the hull, creating those god-awful plastic tabs. A chisel shaped X-Acto blade will make short work of the raised plastic on the surface, and all I need to do then is carefully reinstate the panel lines using the X-Acto knife and the files. A sanding sponge is then used to smooth off the entire surface until it's almost as if those pipes were never there. Using a drill bit which was matched to the diameter of the coated wire, it's then time to insert a hole where the pipe originates in the surface of the hull. As this is just a locating hole and will be filled with super glue, it doesn't need to go all the way through the kit part. This clamp will hold the wire in place while the glue dries and also enables me to bend the wire to the contour of the pipes that used to be moulded onto the surface of the kit. On the other end of that piece of wire, I'm going to make a mark with a pencil where another 90 degree bend needs to be made to take that pipe down into the recessed area of the Falcon's hull. Once this bend is created, I'm going to trim some of the excess wire off with a razor saw, but still leave it slightly longer than necessary, as I'm going to be drilling another locating hole in that recess for the wire to sit in and be held firmly with superglue. And there you can see the first pipe that's been replaced with this method. Certain pipes I can't replace as they're in areas which are too tight. To enhance the detail here and do a quick fix, I'm going to slightly undercut the surface details using the tip of a sharp blade. This will create a bit of extra definition and an area that will hold a pin wash much better to create areas of shadow. Moving on now to the mounting bracket for the satellite dish, and this is one of the worst parts in the kit. This solid plastic is supposed to be more of an open A-frame arrangement and there's actually meant to be some detail in there. Instead of working with what I've got, I'm actually going to cut it off and start from scratch. The large plastic lugs are removed and the top of the mount is flushed off with a sanding pad. To create some new legs for the dish to connect to the bracket, those lugs were kept as a template and then cut out of styrene sheet using a razor saw to help keep everything straight. The second part of the bracket arrangement was made by cutting very fine slithers of the original kit parts away, again using the razor saw. This enabled me to take away a massive amount of plastic and replace it with a much more delicate setup. After throwing a couple of spare kit parts in between the two A-frames and then attaching the new thinner mounting brackets to the top of the A-frames themselves, the whole thing was looking a lot more detailed. The dish itself got treated to an old road wheel on the back and then some styrene rod to create the ribs on the back of the dish. This represents a massive improvement over the kit part and makes it look much more like the dish which actually appeared on the top of the Millennium Falcon. I did promise myself I wouldn't get too caught up in the details, but that really needed to be done. Speaking of nice easy projects to get me back into video making, I decided that now would be a great time to do the first ever lighting that I've ever done on a model kit. This was a huge mistake as I wasn't really prepared for it at all and know absolutely nothing about electronics, but the guy at Maplin very kindly set me up with all of the parts that I need to create some LED lighting in this Millennium Falcon. These parts are going to have to go into the kit itself, however, to provide the lights with power, so I now need to create some wiring channels straight through the undercarriage legs using a large drill. This was easier said than done, however, using plenty of patience with the pin vise, I created two nice neat holes for the wires to feed through, and I now have a seamless wire entry into the kit itself, and then these wires which will attach to the battery pack can be hidden in the model's base. I originally planned to mount the LEDs on this piece of plastic here, which is just behind the blue diffuser which is provided with the kit. However, the distance between the diffuser and the mount is much too small and this doesn't look very good, so this whole thing's gonna need to be removed. Here's where the razor saw comes out to play again and makes short work of the kit's plastic, stripping off that whole thing and leaving me with a massive gaping hole in the back of my model kit. This whole area now needs to be filled in and made ready to accept the LED lighting which is coming its way. Using some styrene sheet, I created a lighting box which fits perfectly into the back of the model and sets the LEDs a good distance away from the opening. The styrene was covered with silver foil to try and help maximise the amount of light being reflected out the opening at the back of the Falcon. The upper portion of the lighting box was stuck to the upper hull surface so that when the model was closed, all of that light was reflected outwards. To give me an engine glow similar to that used in the movie, two blue LEDs and a single white LED should mix together at the back quite nicely. After all this wiring, there's a resistor and then two white LEDs in the front which represent the headlights. To cover up the great big hole at the back of the Falcon, I'm going to be creating a light diffuser which also incorporates an engine grille which is missing from this kit altogether. To create the grille, I'm going to use some styrene strip, and to make sure it all fits perfectly, I'm going to use the blue engine cover from the kit part as a size template. After taping the styrene strips to the blue kit part and then trimming them off, I should be left with two perfectly sized pieces of styrene strip, which when they're bent round to the correct angle, will fit across the back of the Falcon perfectly. Using the cutting mat as a guide, the vertical pieces are then glued into place using liquid poly cement. This sequence has been increased in speed, obviously, however you can see it's quite a tedious job, but the results will be well worth it, as once those little overlapping pieces are trimmed away, what I'm left with is a nice neat grille to fit over the engine. To create the diffuser, I'm simply going to spray some clear plastic acetate with Humbrol glass etch spray. When this dries, it replicates the effect of frosted glass, so it will fog up nicely and diffuse the light from the LEDs. All that's left to do now is give the grill a few coats of black paint and then stick it to the diffuser. After all those improvements are done, and with the diffuser temporarily held on with some tape, it's time to test all of the lighting and make sure everything's working okay, all the circuitry's fine, before moving on to the second part, which is the painting and weathering stages. I'm going to need an entire video just to cover the job that I'm doing on this model kit, but as you can see, if I flip this baby over, I have actually already started filming on part 2, as there's an undercoat and some pre-shading present on there. So that part of the video will be uploaded shortly as soon as I've finished creating my very own paintwork for the Millennium Falcon. I just want to take this opportunity to thank every single one of you for your ongoing support over the past couple of years when I haven't been uploading. I know there's been a lot of comments in that time that have gone unanswered, and the view count has gone through the roof, so I know people keep checking back to see if there's more Scale Model Medic content. Well, now I'm telling you, I am back. I do promise to do more videos, so please keep checking back regularly, and I'll see you again next time.